My name is Maryam Zia and I am from FSC Part 2 from Proctor International School and Colleges.
My name is Farat and I am from Proctor, Lahore.
Our project is on estimation and hazardous effects of BPA, a local brand of baby feeding bottle. Basically, BPA is an endocrine disruptor that mimics a female hormone known as oestrogen. That's why it is a topic under discussion for many years. BPA is basically found in the polycarbonates, canned food containers, and it is being leached out under certain conditions. We did many extractions and analysis. And what we found was BPA is more easily leached in hot environments. And there were three main baby feeding bottle companies in Pakistan which had the maximum amount of BPA being leached out. Microwave oven has a great effect on leaching of BPA, as well as the older the feeder is, the more will be the leaching, whereas the newer the feeder is, the lesser will be the leaching.
And we did some experimental work for the extraction of that BPA. First of all, we had some chemicals like chloroform, acetone, nitrile, acetone and bisphenol A. And we had a standard solution. Then we gave some normal conditions to the baby feeder. And after that, we put their feeders filled with water in the microwave oven for 1, 2 and 3 minutes respectively. Then after that, we add some chemicals like acetone, chloroform. And there's a cloudy formation in the solution. And then we centrifuge that solution in the centrifugal machine for 3,000 rotations per minute. And 3,000 rotations per minute. And then after that, there was a segmented layer of bisphenol A at the bottom. So we separated it by pasture paper. And we did the analysis of that bisphenol A by a UV spectrometer.
As I told you before, that we use three brand companies of Pakistan, that is Shield, Kitco and Makiko. You can see from the graphs, we have done comparison between the three companies, and what we saw was, as she told you, that we used two kinds of chemicals. One solution was spiked and the other was unspiked. The spiked solution has more amount of BPA leached in it, and the environment we had was a hot environment, and we created four different kinds of environment. First, we placed it in sunlight for 2 days, then we microwaved it for 1, 2 and 3 minutes. What we saw was that the baby feeding bottle, which is placed in microwave for a longer time, has more BPA leached, whereas the next bar graph shows the heights. The blue and the red color shows the lower, newer and the older feeder. You can see the red indicates the older feeder, which means more BPA is leached in older feeder.
Okay, so now there is an alternative method for bisphenol A, and that is oleoresin. In oleoresin, it is a mixture of oleoresin and it is extracted from plants, and that is not much expensive, but that can be used as an alternative method for BPA. And there are as well some precautions for BPA that government should ban at BPA. We should not use canned foods, and we should not put the feeders into the microwave oven. And there are 7 types of plastics, and 3 and 6 plastics should not be used because they contain BPA.
Last but not the least is our conclusion. As I told you before, that the BPA needs a hot environment, so the bottle which were microwaved for 3 and 4 minutes has the more BPA leached, and the older the bottle is, the more the BPA is being leached. Let's talk about the common sources of BPA. BPA commonly is in plastic bottles, in baby feeding bottles, in canned foods, in dental fillings, in contact lenses. How you can reduce this by taking precautions, that's all. Government should ban the use of plastic bottles that contain code 3 and 6. They should use 1, 2, 4 and 5. Whereas mothers should avoid using feeders which contains BPA. They should use BPA-free containers, or they should mimic the amount of the feeder they are using, as in for 2 months or 1 month.